Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-day. My, oh my, what a wonderful day. Plenty of sunshine going my way.
Oh, hey.
Zippity-doo-dah.
Welcome back. I'm Mr. Kevin with Central Kids.
And hello to you, boys and girls. I'm Miss Suzanne.
Hey, Miss Suzanne, I am so glad you're back with us today.
I'm glad to be here. What you got cooked up for us today?
Well, I think maybe we should get started by singing a fun song. So everybody get up out of your chairs and get ready to join the worship team in this fun song. Let's go.
Your home. I don't know where you eat your meals or where you talk on the phone. I don't know if you got a cook, a butler, or a maid. I don't know if you got a yard with a hammock in the shade. I don't know if you got some shelter, say a place to hide. I don't know if you live with friends and who you can confide. I don't know if you got a family, say a mom or dad. I don't know if you love it all, but I bet you wish you had. Come and go with me to my father's house. Come and go with me to my father's house. It's a big, big house with lots and lots of room. A big, big table with lots and lots of food. A big, big yard where we can play football. A big, it's my father's house. Father's house, come and go with me to my father's house. It's a big, big house with lots and lots of room. A big, big table with lots and lots of food. A big, big yard where we can play football. A big, big house, it's my father's house. A big, big house with lots and lots of room. It's my father's house.
I love that song. It's one of my favorites.
That's good. It's one of my favorites too. Hey, Suzanne, do you remember last month I was teaching everybody about birds?
Yes, I do remember. And you know what? I learned something about birds because of that.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, that's great. Uh-huh. That's what we wanted to do, is teach everybody something new. So, Miss Suzanne, this month I decided to teach everyone something different.
Oh, so something different. Well, what is that going to be?
Well, I'll give you a hint with this joke.
Okay.
What kind of food would you eat during a drought?
Let me think. That's kind of tough. There's usually not much food around in a drought. I don't know, Mr. Kevin. What kind of food is there around during a drought?
You would have to eat sandwiches.
Sandwiches? Yeah. Oh, maybe that's because it's so dry that all there is sand.
You know it, Miss Suzanne. Yep.
Yeah. So that means you're going to be teaching us about maybe a different kind of food?
No. No, we're not going to learn about food. I'm going to teach you about the weather.
Awesome. So whether you learn something about the weather or not, it's going to be great.
Well, alrighty then. The first weather thing I want you to learn about is a drought. Take a look at these pictures as I tell you about droughts. A drought is a time period when there has been no precipitation, like rain, sleet, or snow, to water the ground. Droughts can cause animals to die and the land to dry up.
You know what, Kevin? Droughts sound really bad.
They really are. When I visited Africa many years ago, they were in the middle of a drought. And the people that lived out in the wilderness, they would start fires, hoping the smoke would go up into the sky and create rain.
Oh, that would be great. If we knew somebody who had superpowers, who could change the weather whenever they wanted to, they could make it rain.
Yeah, that would be pretty cool.
Yeah.
But, you know, there's only one person who has enough power to change the weather, and that's God. Let's take a look at our big question.
Okay.
The big question is, drum roll please, how many gods are there?
And the answer is, drum roll please, the one true God who alone deserves our worship.
You know, we were talking about droughts a few minutes ago. The Bible story today is actually about a drought too.
Well, let's take a look at it. Now, as you're watching the Bible story, boys and girls, think about how God proved that He is the only one true God.
Elijah the prophet spoke to Ahab, the evil king of Israel, and gave him a message. There will be no dew or rain for the next few years unless I command it. This will certainly happen.
Oh no!
Then God told Elijah to go to a place near a stream. God said the ravens would provide food for Elijah to eat. So Elijah obeyed God. The ravens brought him bread and meat, and he drank water from the stream. After a while, the stream dried up because there was no rain in the land. Then God told Elijah to go to a small village. God said a widow in the town would provide for Elijah. So Elijah obeyed God. When Elijah got to the gate of the city, he saw a widow gathering wood. He called to her, "Please bring me a little water so I can drink." As she went to get it, he added, "Please bring me a piece of bread too." But the woman told Elijah, "I don't have bread. I only have a little bit of flour and oil." The woman and her son were planning to eat one more meal before they died from hunger. "Don't be afraid," Elijah said. "Go and prepare the meal, but first bring me a small loaf of bread. Then make some for yourself and your son. God says you will not run out of flour or oil until rain comes again." So the woman prepared the meal. She, Elijah, and everyone in her household had enough to eat, and she did not run out of flour or oil, just like the Lord had said. Sometime later, the woman's son got sick, and he stopped breathing. Elijah took the boy upstairs and laid him on the bed. He cried out to God, stretched himself out over the boy three times, and cried out to God again. "Lord, my God, please let this boy live again," Elijah prayed. The Lord listened to Elijah, and the boy's life came into him again. He was alive. Elijah led the boy to his mother. She said to Elijah, "Now I know you are a man of God, and the Lord really does speak through you."
Wow! Stopping the rain because of an evil king, giving the widow unending oil and flour, and bringing a boy back to life, that's a lot. There really is no other God besides the one true God, period.
Yep. We've talked about before how each story in the Bible shows us something amazing about God. Every story in the Bible points us to Jesus. How do you think the story of Elijah and the widow points us to Jesus?
Well, okay, then let's take a look at that video, shall we?
God miraculously provided through Elijah to give food to the widow and life to the widow's son. Many years later, God miraculously provided through his own son, Jesus. Jesus is greater than Elijah. In Jesus, God provides salvation and life to everyone who trusts in him.
Get your hand on my cookie jar.
Hey, hey, Mr. Kevin, what? And all of you out there, look. Look what I have just invented, a brand new product.
You just invented a box, huh? Oh, I see. It says replenishing flour. That sounds pretty cool. Doesn't replenishing mean that it never runs out?
Well, it kind of. It actually does run out, but it replenishes and fills back up again.
It does?
Yes.
All by itself?
It yes. Will,
wow.
Yes, and that's why I'm so excited about it. Here, why don't you, that means, oh goodness, I've knocked the bowl over. So you know what that means? Nobody ever has to go hungry again.
Wow, I can't wait to see that.
Yeah, so okay, so great. Why don't you pick up the box and pour some in the bowl?
Okay, let's go. There's a little bit. Mm. I think it's pretty much empty though.
Oh no. Are you sure about that, Mr. Kevin?
What? It was just empty. How did you do that? I guess it, let me try it. Oh, look. I guess you used it all up that time.
No, I don't think so. Remember, Kevin, it's replenishing flour. It replenishes.
No way. How did you do that? Let me try. Oh, look. It's empty. There's nothing coming out of that, a little bit. How are you doing that?
See, it comes out. I told you it's replenishing flour. It's just like the widow in the Bible story where she had oil and flour that she didn't run out.
Wow, but God is the only one who can do that, just like our big question says. Drum roll, please. There's only one true God who deserves worship.
Oh, one true God. Okay, Mr. Kevin, you're right. We really don't have replenishing flour in the box.
I knew it.
Inside the box, there's two components. There's flour on one side, but there's not on the other. So if you had picked up the box and turned it around,
yep.
then the flour would have poured out.
Like this?
Yep.
Oops.
Oh, you silly guy. How that was kind of fun. Okay, so God is the only one who deserves our praise, not some made-up box.
Wow. Hey, that is a great way to introduce this month's memory verse.
Okay, yeah.
Let's take a look at it together.
Okay.
How about everybody out there, y'all read it with us on 3, 2, 1.
I am the Lord, that is my name, and I will not give my glory to another or my praise to idols. Isaiah 42:8.
Doesn't that worship team have a great song to help us remember the words of our memory verse?
Yep. They sure do, Miss Suzanne.
Yeah.
So everybody get up and get ready to move and sing with our team. Yay. Let's go.
Yay.
I am the Lord. God caused the drought because the people didn't worship him. They worshiped false gods, idols made of stone and wood and plastic.
Oh, sorry.
Made of Kevin and plastic.
You know, that reminds us that God will not share his glory with anyone else.
No, sir. There is one true God who alone deserves worship.
Before we're finished today, let's bow our heads together and close our eyes and worship God through prayer. Let's go. God, thank you that you have all glory and power. Help us trust you alone. We know that no other God exists beside you. We know that you provide for your people. Thank you for sending Jesus. We love you. In Jesus' name, amen. Hey, we're so glad you joined us today, kids.
Yeah, make sure that you watch again next week.